Hello and welcome to today's daily market update with me, Joshua Mahoney, research analyst here at Alpari UK. Now, the global indices are trading higher off the back of the news over the weekend that despite the UN having actually said that chemical weapons were used in Damascus, the US is actually seeking Congress approval for any military action, and therefore people are expecting to see further delays in potential conflict in the area. Now, we were expecting to see downside off the back of potentially any conflict in terms of the indices, and we were expecting to see further upside in the likes of gold, in the likes of crude oil. And so some of these have really been reversed today, where people think that potentially there's going to be a little bit of a delay, essentially. Now, you can see that over the weekend, we did have Brent crude gap down lower, and it has erased a number of those gains that we saw last week. And this is, again, associated with this Syrian delay and potential conflict going forward. Now, it's going to be likely to have low volumes today off the back of Labor Day holiday over in the US. Sometimes that can bring greater volatility. However, it's worth bearing in mind that people are starting to come back from their holidays, so that's likely to bring up some of the volumes on the flip side. Now, today is really PMI manufacturing day, where we have had over the weekend in China, we saw the manufacturing PMI figure come out, and that was around about 51 from 50.3. Now, it is a beat from estimates and it's strong for the region. People have, of course, been speculating about the recent downturn and the lowered growth in the Chinese region and the knock-on effects that has upon some of the other major economies in the world. However, you know, a post of 51 is a strong number. Bearing in mind, we also are looking forward to this HSBC manufacturing PMI figure, which is generally a lot lower because it does factor in some of the more medium and smaller companies, whereas this headline figure from the Chinese region is generally focused upon the larger companies within the country. Also today, we have had the UK manufacturing PMI figure. Now, that came well above expectation at 57.2. A massive beat from last month, and so really strong figure going into tomorrow, where we're going to get the construction PMI figure, and then Wednesday where we get that all important services PMI figure. So that's a very good start. It's a 2.5 year high, and that's really boosted cable and some of the markets off the back of that. Now, also we've had a couple of manufacturing PMI figures out of the Eurozone. Ordinarily, people wouldn't pay too much attention to the likes of Spain and Italy because everyone really wants to know how the likes of Germany are really getting on. However, I think it's really important to note that, you know, where people have been seeing strength within the Eurozone recently, a lot of that has been attributed to the likes of France and Germany. And it's interesting to note that some of those peripheral countries are where the worries really lie. So where we actually see both the Italian and the Spanish manufacturing PMI figures today beat expectations, both have moved into expansion. You know, that's very positive for both of those, and it's positive for the Eurozone as a whole. So that's something to note for the day. So that's it for today, guys. And if you want any more news and analysis, come and check out the Alpari newsroom at alpari.co.uk/newsroom. Or check me out on Twitter. My name is Joshua Mahoney, research analyst here at Alpari UK. Have a great day.